Hey, horror fans, once again, it is me, the Horror Minds of Mindy G. It's time to do another horror movie review. This time, I'm going to review the Italian horror film, A Classic Horror Story. Now, A Classic Horror Story is a 2021 Italian horror film that was directed by Roberto DiFio and Paolo Strapilli. It was written by Lucio Bassano, Robert DiPio, and Paolo Strapilli. Now, the film stars Matilda Lutz, Francesco Russo, Ilya Sobel, Will Merrick, and Pepetino Mazzata. I think I got that name right. Now, in this gruesome suspense film, strangers traveling in southern Italy become stranded in the woods where they have to fight desperately in order to survive. Ooh. Now, when it comes to horror foreign films, most can be just as scary or just as good as their American counterparts. While some of those films can come from an original idea, others are based on stories from American horror films. Case in point, the Polish horror film, Nobody Sleeps in the Woods Tonight, is a prime example, as it borrows heavily from Friday the 13th and Sleepaway Camp. They're both set in the camp, and both of these, and that film is set at a camp. The French horror film Revenge has vibes of I Spit on Your Grave and The Last House on the Left. So those are some examples of some foreign horror films that have, you know, similar stories to their American counterparts. But some foreign horror films actually come up with their own original ideas. And I like those too. And like I said, most of them do, you know, cater to some of this stuff that they've probably seen in American cinemas. Which brings us to the latest Italian horror movie from filmmakers Roberto DiFio and Paolo Strapilli, A Classic Horror Story. Now, the setup is similar and familiar one as four strangers decide to take a carpool together to southern Italy. Now, while traveling through a rural area, the camper they're in crashes, and the next thing they know, they're in the middle of nowhere. There's no roads, nothing, no way to communicate. You know, we've seen this all setting before in American film, horror films too. The only thing they see is a weird looking house, and when they go inside, they see these weird drawings of three men wearing crazy looking masks inside, you know, similar to those masks that we see in the Wrong Turn remake. Doesn't take long before the strangers have to fight to stay alive as someone or something is now after them. Now, while watching this film, I'm sure everyone will be getting a lot of vibes from American horror films, specifically A Cabin in the Woods, Wrong Turn, and Friday the 13th. There are elements of all three of these films in this one. You have the cabin in the middle of the woods, nowhere. You have some vibes of Friday the 13th in there, because we got a lot of people, and there are young people in this particular one. And, of course, there are certain scenes that will come from Wrong Turn. I mean, even the driver of the camper, Fabrizio, even talks about horror films and things they shouldn't do or they'll be killed. It's an interesting way of taking it on there, because he goes on his little tirade about saying, this reminds me of some horror films I've seen, where, you know, where the killer's out there, we're all in the middle of the woods and nowhere, nothing's working. So he said, and he actually says, it looks like we're in a classic horror story. And he's right, there actually are in a similar thing that happens in a classic horror story. Now, whether or not this is a classic horror movie, we'll find out later. Now, I will give credit to directors Roberto and Paolo as they set the tone that is needed for this type of movie. In certain scenes, they use a dark red color palette when something bad is about to happen, or when Fabrizio talks about a childhood horror story his grandmother told him. He goes in this nice sort of horror story that I think is some type of a legend that kind of deals with what's happening in the film right now. And I kind of like that kind of aspect of the film. Kind of reminded me of Mandy, how they use a color palette in this one. Another thing I like about Roberto's and Paolo's script is that it does a good job of developing the characters, as we see in the beginning with Elisa, who's pregnant but is obviously that her mother doesn't want to have one. We can see that she's torn between wanting to have the baby but wanting to also finish school, and we see that aspect of Elisa in this particular film, and we start to care about her. There's a good Dr. Ricardo, who has his own issues, and then we have Sophia and her boyfriend Mark. They're kind of sort of the cliche characters in this particular film. Speaking of Revenge, Matilda Lutz, who starred in that particular film, is pretty good as the conflicted Elisa. Or Elsa, I think that's, Elsa or Elisa, I think that's how it's pronounced her name. She gives her the sad and confused look We believe that she seems to be the weakest of the group. Later on, she starts showing strength and courage and trying to get everyone on board so that they can all survive. There's a little thing that happens towards the second act of the film, which I won't reveal, but then she starts becoming a very caring person in this particular film, and she's the one that starts getting the people to believe, we gotta survive this, we have to stick together. Now, while I like the idea about who is hunting everyone, because it's something we haven't seen before in a horror picture, so I give them credit, it's the twist that comes during the third act that kind of bothers me a bit. Now, while I wasn't surprised because I had a feeling that was going to happen due to what I saw in the beginning of the film, but when the twist happens, it kind of throws it off because it kind of doesn't fit this type of a movie. Now, don't get me wrong, I don't mind seeing a twist in a horror movie or any other movie, but it has to make some type of sense in order to make it believable. The Book of Eli is a good example of a twist that no one saw coming, and it kind of fits the story that was being told in that film. There are other twists. I'm pretty sure a lot of people think about the twist that happened in M. Night Shyamalan films. Those twists no one really saw coming, especially in The Sixth Sense, but they kind of fit to what the story was, and it makes sense because there were clues that were dropped in those films. Here in this film, we really don't get any clues. Maybe one part in the film that we do get a clue, but not enough clues to when the twist happens, he's going to say, huh? I'm guessing that the filmmakers thought this would be some type of a shock value, but it doesn't come as a shock. It's kind of a bit of a disappointment to me. Now, when the twist happens in this one, it kind of takes away some of the tension and suspense, and it kind of cheapens the actions about who was attacking everyone in this particular film. It kind of didn't make any sense, and I really didn't appreciate what happened, and I really didn't like the ending as well. Now, we do get some decent kills, and we do have some nice practical effects in the film, so I will give the filmmakers credit because we do get some decent kills in this film. We get some nice gore and blood. Not enough to satisfy you gore hounds in there, but it's good enough for some people. Overall, it's a okay horror film. You know, it's got a decent acting from the cast, and as I mentioned, as I stated earlier before, it's a combination of Friday the 13th, Wrong Turn, and The Cabin in the Woods. It's an okay foreign horror picture. It's not going to knock anybody's socks off. It's okay, but you know, I've seen better foreign horror films than this one. So I'm going to give a classic horror story. Only 2 out of my 5 bloody gold coins. Only 2 out of my 5 bloody gold coins. Yeah, the twist didn't make any sense. It kind of took away some aspects of the film. But the acting is decent. Like I said, we do get some nice kill scenes in the picture. I just wish they would have focused a little bit more on who was attacking them. Because I kind of like that aspect of the film. Because, again, it's something different that we haven't seen before. And not even American horror films, but foreign horror films as well. So there you have it. That is my video and review for A Classic Horror Story. Hope you did enjoy it. And if you did, please give it a thumbs up, like, and share because it does help out with the YouTube algorithm. This is now playing on Netflix. So you have seen it. Please leave a comment section in the comment section below and tell me what you thought about A Classic Horror Story. Also, if you're new here, please hit that subscriber button and ring that notification bell. That way you'll be notified anytime when I put up new videos such as this one. Once again, my name is Lamont Smith, better known as the Horror Miser Monty G, and always remember that horror rules. Ha ha! I'll see you in my next video. I'm out.